Angeles, and welcome to Virtual Experiences. It's Friday, so it's Hit the Trails. Sorry for the delay. We were waiting for the weather to kind of cooperate, and we didn't want to get our technology totally soaked. So today you're joining me at Oakwoods Nature Reserve, and this area is what we call the meadow. Some people call it the prairie. So if you were to continue on, right over here is Schenck Lake, and there's a little bridge that leads over to the other prairie. I refer to it as the meadow, that's just me. So this is a grass area that has some natural growing flowers. There are some prairie flowers that grow in here. We maintain it by burning it every couple of years, because if we didn't, succession would happen and we would have all woods. And so we want it to say grassland component with these flowers and smaller grass plants, because it attracts different kinds of animals by having it that way. It's not really in its glory right now. The time to visit it would be August. So when it's hot and the sun's beating down, that's when a lot of our prairie flowers and grasses will be out. So I encourage you to come back to visit it there. I also wanted to talk a little bit about some of these boxes that maybe you've been out to hike and you're seeing out here and wondering, what are they used for? So the two small ones in front of me, and we have these kind of throughout our meadow area, are nesting boxes that we put up for eastern bluebirds. Now, we also can attract tree swallows, we can also get house wrens, chickadees, and tufted titmice. And so you might be thinking, why do we put these up? Well, these birds that I just mentioned are cavity nesters. And so they're not like a woodpecker who can drill their own hole with their beak. Their beaks aren't situated for that. They have to rely on a natural cavity forming in a tree, or that secondary cavity, because a downy woodpecker is not going to live in the same hole at the home it made the year before. Or you can put up these nest boxes. We're going to have on our website plans for these nest boxes that Division of Wildlife has put out, because there is certain criteria that you have to have in order to attract certain birds. Those songbirds are not the only ones that live in nest box. We also have a wood duck box that we just put up here. And so depending on what type of bird you might want to attract is the type of house that you want to build. So usually these go up if you want to put one out in April. That's when birds are starting to nest. And you can then figure out what type of bird you're getting by the type of nest that it has. So a bluebird is going to use all grass material, all dried grass material. The tree swallow looks very similar, except they have feathers that they kind of line in their nest. So the bluebirds, of course, most of you may be familiar with, it's the bluebirds with the orange breasts, very small, weighing only about an ounce, with about a 9 to 11 inch wingspan. A tree swallow is very similar, a little less, even less than an ounce in weight, with a little over a foot wingspan. They have a white belly, and then their back is a kind of greenish, bluish, iridescent. Warning, they will protect the nest box, the tree swallows, and they will kind of dive bomb at you and let you know that you're kind of invading their space. If you have house wrens and you're playing and you want to track them, you want to put your nest box a little closer to the woods. I'm actually hearing some calling right now, because they build their nest with sticks. And so if you've got a lot of sticks, then you're getting the house wrens. The one that we're scanning on right now, the larger one, is actually a new purple martin box that was an Eagle Scout project, and it was put up here just a couple of weeks ago. And so they're not natural cavity nesters in the eastern part of the United States, that's more in the western part. So they like to live in colonies. So think of it as a little apartment complex where you've got each individual unit, but then a bigger space to hold all of that. So I'm not sure if we have any activity right now out here just yet with that, but they're gonna be, like the name implies, kind of darker blue, purple, iridescent color, larger than our bluebirds and our swallows. They're gonna be a little over a couple ounces in weight, and the wingspan's about 15 to 16 inches. With your nest box, you will have to take care of them through the season. One problem we had is house sparrows, which is a non-native bird that will like to nest and outcompete those native ones. So if you're going to put any kind of nesting box out, you do want to read about what care is involved and to monitor that. You don't want to leave it up and then just kind of let it go. If you bought a box that's more decorative And you put it out, if it's not designed for a special kind of bird, you might not attract anything but house sparrows. So if you want it out just for decoration, that's fine. I would put something over the hole so nothing can nest inside. So coming up to Oakwoods, it's clear, but yet the rain is still kind of happening today. The weather's gonna be beautiful this weekend, nice and clear. No, I don't think anything is in here just yet. Well, there's a few sticks, but I didn't want to bother if something was in there kind of building. If you're monitoring, you kind of know what's going on in the nest box there. Again, join us on Monday for our virtual experience with our discovery stories at 1 o'clock. Enjoy the parks, stay on the trail. Thanks for joining us and have a great day.